The story of the Lord. Man is born on this earth to do some work. Karma. This is called the Karma Bhumi, where man has to do some work or other by which he may choose to remain here only, birth after birth, or can get elevated to higher spheres or get condemned to a lower status. Man is the maker of his own destiny. He cannot live without doing some work or other. Waking, sleeping, or dreaming, he does work. He experiences. While waking, one works for getting some food, others for clothing, others for shelter, others for education, yet others for cure of some disease. But having achieved all these, a man is not satisfied. He is not happy. He thinks out, is this all the purpose of life? To him, religion shows a way out. In whatever way this inquiry starts in man, it will lead to the inquiry about the Lord. Wherever there is a desire for satisfaction, there starts an unobstructed, ceaseless devotion towards the Lord. That will lead to the evolution of man. Devotion to God leads to renunciation and knowledge. Efforts which are not dedicated to God are useless. Those who seek liberation do not seek for gaining material wealth. The inquiry about the Lord or Self is called true knowledge. It is called Atmavidya. This knowledge is available in the Upanishads. The Lord or Self is called therein as Brahman. Others call him as Paramatma and yet others call him as God. Those who are endowed with the qualities of renunciation, knowledge and devotion perceive the Lord in their own hearts. Righteous living leads to devotion. God is pleased with people who lead a righteous life. Constant hearing of the Lord's stories leads to knowledge. Single-pointed hearing of his stories and constant praising of his glory relieves the attachment to actions. That is renunciation. Those who are desirous of hearing the Lord's stories will find no taste for other enjoyments. The Lord dwells in the hearts of those who are eager to hear his stories. He protects them from all kinds of harm. When evil tendencies are eliminated, devotion increases. The mind gets free from tamas and rajas, dullness and overactivity. Such people like isolation. They acquire true knowledge of the self. All their doubts get dissolved. They no more possess ahankar, which is a sign of ignorance. Their ego is eliminated. They are free from the reactions of their own actions. Brahman is all-pervading and is present everywhere. He is vitalizing the whole world, both the moving and unmoving, the sentient and inert. He functions in three aspects, as Brahma when rajas dominates, as Vishnu when sattva predominates, and as Shiva when tamas predominates. Sattva is better than rajas and rajas is better than tamas. Sages who are mostly dominated by sattva worship Brahman who is beyond the three gunas. Others worship other gods for the sake of worldly gains. Those longing for wealth, progeny and property worship the demigods and the manes. Those who are desirous of liberation renounce the association of objects and would be longing to hear the stories of the Lord. The Lord in his original state is associated with Mahatattva Ahankar, the Tanmatras, and would be having the 16 Kalas as described in the Prashnopanishad. Sixth question. They are 1. Prana, 2. Faith, 3. Space, 4. Wind, 5. Fire, 6. Water, 7. Earth, which are the 5 great elements, 8. The senses, 9. Mind, 10. Food, 11. Strength, 12. Thoughts, 13. Mantra, Manana Shakti, 14. Karma, actions, 15. World of activity, 16. Names. He shines in the 5 great elements in his pure sattva guna. He excels all others in his radiance. He takes a human form, having hands, legs, thighs, body, face, ears, eyes, nose and head, and shines in the full glory of his own, wearing fine dress, ornaments, garlands, crown, and rests on the thousand-headed serpent. Adisesha in the ocean of milk, in his yoga nitra or apparent sleep, with his consort Lakshmi to attend to his comforts. He always holds the Shankh, Chakra, Gada and Padma in his four hands. That is the beginning for all the manifestations or avatars. Only great sages of pure Sattva Guna will be able to perceive the Lord in this state. From his navel, there is a lotus flower coming out, and out of the lotus, Brahma, the creator, is born. Brahma, in his turn, creates all the manifesting worlds. Vedanta declares that every manifestation of life is an incarnation of Brahman. I am Atma Brahma, Tattvam Asi, Aham Brahma Asmi. But the Puranas restrict this application only to those in which the Lord thought fit for himself to enact through them. These avatars are counted as 10 in some places, 21 in some places, and many more in others. Some are recounted here. The first avatar of the Lord mentioned in the Puranas is the Varaha or the boar shape. Hiranyaksha, a Rakshasa whose ambition was after wealth, had usurped the whole of the earth, yet he was not satisfied. He was a personification of Mamakar, the feeling of mine. He made life impossible for other creatures, including man, to live upon this earth. All of them prayed to the Lord, who appeared as a boar and searched for the demon. He destroyed the demon and elevated the drowned earth to the surface of the waters and made it available for the inhabitation of living beings. In this effort, his claws helped him. The next avatar was that of Suyagna, born to the creator Swayambhu and Akuti. He created all the godly angels and relieved the distress of the world. Narada is supposed to be one of the avatars of the Lord, and we will be hearing a small story about him year long. The Lord appeared as Nara and Narayana and performed great tapas in the Himalayas, not for any personal gains, but for blessing the whole living kingdom on earth. The place where they performed this great tapas is now called Holy Badrinath. The two mountains there are supposed to be the symbols for Nara and Narayana, and all pilgrims who go there worship them in addition to the Lord Badrinath. The Lord was born as Kapila Maharishi, a Siddha Purusha who propagated Sankhya philosophy and gave liberation to his own mother. Dattatreya is considered as an avatar. He was born to Atri Maharishi, one who was beyond the three gunas, and to Anasuya, one who was never covetous of anybody, an ideal wife and mother. Dattatreya taught the knowledge of the self to great jnanis like Prahlada and others. The Lord was born as Rishabha to Nabi out of Meru Devi and taught the Paramahamsa Marga to the learned. Born as Prithu Chakravarti, he established righteousness in the world. The Lord was born as a great fish, Matsyavatar, to save the Vedas and the original seeds of all species from the great deluge. When the Devas and Rakshasas were churning the milk ocean for the sake of nectar, the Lord first became the tortoise to support the Mandara mountain. Then he came out of the ocean as Dhanvantri with the Kalasha of nectar in his hands. When the Devas and the Danavas were fighting for the Kalasha, the Lord took the form of Mohini, beauty in solid form, and promised to distribute the nectar equally to all of them. But while the Danvas were admiring her beauty, she had emptied the vessel among the Devas and disappeared. He appeared as the lion man to destroy the demon, Hiranyakashipu, the personification of Ahankar, I-ness, and thus to save Prahlada, the greatest Bhakta. Next, he was born as Vamana, the short little Brahmachari who became the Trivikrama and ousted Bali Chakravarti from his usurped seat and returned the kingdom of the gods to Indra. Then he was born as Parashurama, a Brahmin who acted as a Kshatriya in destroying all the evil kings. He was born as Vyasa to edit all the Vedas. He was born as Sri Ramachandra who established a code of human conduct by his ideal life. From childhood to old age, at every stage, he showed the way of conduct for others to follow. His life history has become the sacred Ramayana, which is an eternal source of inspiration and knowledge for generations from the Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Then he was born to Balarama and Shri Krishna, whose stories are innumerable and fill the greater part of Bhagavata. Buddha is considered to be an avatar of the Lord throughout India, who propagated ahimsa and universal brotherhood. He condemned the evils that were perpetrated in the country in the name of the Vedas and religion. Lastly, he is to be born as Kalki in this Kali Yuga to put down evil and establish righteousness. Thus, the avatars range from the lowest animal manifestation to the celestial gods and indirectly confirm the Vedantic gospel that every living creature is his manifestation and he is all-pervading. Everything exists in him. He exists in everything, but he is not modified by anything.